We had Senator Roland Mullen, independent Senator Roland Mullen, on the show, I think it was last Friday week, claiming that the upcoming referendum on blasphemy, you'll be voting on that under the 26th as well as for a new president, the referendum to remove the crime of blasphemy from the Constitution was a total waste of time and money. He said it was nothing more than a vanity project on behalf of the government and was being driven by what he called the PC brigade in this country.
Think of your appendix. It's there. There's no point in getting rid of it if it's not given trouble. This is a costly exercise, a vanity project. I think it shows you a political class living in Leinster House in a bubble of their own, disconnected from the concerns of ordinary voters, because they're going to spend €3 million, give or take, tacking on this question.
Well, I don't know if he'd consider himself to be one of the PC brigade or not, but John Hamill is on the line of the Atheist Ireland group, because they this week have launched their campaign for a yes vote in the referendum to remove the blasphemy provision from the Constitution. John, good morning.
Morning, Alvin.
Thanks for joining us. Well, do you want to respond to Ronan Mullen, first of all, in relation to it being a waste of time and money?
Indeed, yes. So first, I think it's worth noting that when our blasphemy legislation was introduced in the Oireachtas in 2009, I believe, Ronan Mullen voted against that law. So Ronan didn't think it was a good idea then. And I have to say I agree with that, because this law speaks to more than just our national legislation. We have international responsibilities in this area. And so, for example, when we launched our campaign, we presented an open letter signed by dozens of people from Christian and other religious minorities in other countries who are the victims of blasphemy laws. And so, for example, there's a lady called Asya Bibi, who's a Christian lady in Pakistan, who's currently on death row, waiting to be executed in Pakistan for blasphemy. And when Pakistan was last at the UN on this topic, they attempted to introduce into international law exactly the verbatim language from the Irish Blasphemy Act into international law. So as lots of countries around the world criticize places like Pakistan, where they execute Christian minorities for blasphemy.
Okay, but we're not Pakistan, or we're not any of those countries that you mentioned. There is an element here that, John, it's a little bit, it's like an Irish answer to an Irish question. It's on the statute books, yet it's never really been enforced. So that begs the argument, do we really need to change it if it's not really been enforced?
There's two points on that. Firstly, when Christian minorities and people in other countries ask us to say, please stand with us in solidarity in opposing these blasphemy laws under which they're being executed, I don't think it's a good idea for us to turn our back on them. And secondly, when you refer to our own situation here in Ireland, you know, one of the reasons why there's been no prosecutions for blasphemy in Ireland is that the media self-censors themselves. So when particularly print publications are looking at any discussion of any topic that might be considered blasphemous, and this has happened to me personally, the media will just not publish it. And we've seen that with, for example, The Savage Eye, which is the skit show, Dave McSavage's skit show at RTE. Some of his skits were withdrawn because RTE thought they might be blasphemous. So one of the reasons why there are no publications here which are prosecuted for blasphemy is because the media self-censors themselves.
Okay, well, some might argue they self-censor themselves less so for those of the Catholic faith than other faiths. So in a quirky, strange sort of way, this may take the pressure, might it, do you think, off the Catholic Church in terms of some of the criticism it has been receiving? I don't know if you'd agree with that assessment.
I think the good principle to follow in this area, the good rule of thumb, is that no person, no individual is beneath respect, but no idea is above criticism. So if we consider a person from any religious faith, whether it's Catholic or anyone else, and we shouldn't discriminate against or persecute or attack people because of their religious faith, and that includes Roman Catholics.
Yeah, and I think most decent-minded people would acknowledge that to be the case. But come on, €3 million, John. €3 million for this referendum. Surely there are more important things that we should be doing with €3 million and more important referenda to organise.
When I look at the people on death row who are ready to be executed for blasphemy, who are asking Ireland, please don't support the regimes around the world in their arguments about blasphemy by retaining your blasphemy law. And our blasphemy law is cited as best practice in the United Nations by Pakistan when they justify why they're going to execute ladies like Asia Bibi, Christian ladies, for blaspheming. And I think that's money well spent. So you can make that argument about any law or any provision in our constitution at all. You could look at all of the salaries paid to all of the Oireachtas members, including Ronan Mullen, and add them all up and figure and suggest, well, why do we need to pay millions of euros in salaries for our politicians?
Okay.
Well, the answer is because running a democracy costs money, and if we want to keep our constitution and our legislative framework aligned with human rights standards, that costs money.
Okay, there was a suggestion, well, there was a direct allegation from Senator Mullen, a clip of which you heard, that the government and Minister Charlie Flanagan is kowtowing to groups like yourself, who emphasise the absolute need for separation of church and state. There is an element, perhaps, of Catholic church bashing as well. Is that the case? Do you think the government are bowing to the needs of groups like yourself in having this referendum when there's no real immediate need for it? Have you been lobbying hard for it?
Yes, Roland's exactly right that we have been lobbying and campaigning on this and other issues for around 10 years now, so we're delighted that we're finally having a referendum on it. But I think it's a bit rich for people who come from the Catholic tradition in Ireland to complain that Ireland is participating in Catholic bashing. You know, 96% of the state-funded schools in this country are managed by the Catholic Church. Many of our state-funded hospitals are managed by the Catholic Church. We have a Christian prayer in our Dáil before the business starts. You can't be president of Ireland without taking a Christian oath. You can't be the Taoiseach of the Taoiseach without taking a Christian oath. And, you know, we have a country here in Ireland that has a set of laws that were defined when we were an extremely Catholic country. And actually, the population has moved way beyond that now. The population is way ahead of our legislative framework. And really, the legislative framework is catching up. And so, yeah, for some people, equality feels like oppression if you've been privileged for so long. And the Catholic Church has been privileged for so long in Ireland that when they lose some of their unearned privileges, it can feel like oppression. But really, I think what we're doing here is the right thing in terms of bringing our legislative framework into line with human rights standards.
Okay.
And those who would like us to continue to abuse people's human rights in service of Roman Catholic doctrine, I think are on the wrong side of this argument.
John, thanks for your comments this morning. John Hamill there of Atheist Ireland. And the most important thing, I suppose, is to highlight the fact that there is a vote, there is a referendum on the blasphemy issue. I think it's something we'll have to organise to have a head-to-head debate on before polling day on the 26th of October, because there's still an element of confusion about aspects of that referendum.